Welcome to Market of the Week. I'm Dan Gramza, and today we're going to be exploring the March Japanese yen futures market. The Japanese yen is a part of the $100 billion FX market traded at the CME Group. There are 55 FX futures contracts, 24 FX options, and over 150 countries are represented in the CME Group FX complex. The yen is also a part of the micro FX complex and provides another way to gain exposure to the yen. Like other CME Group futures, FX futures trade virtually 24 hours a day, and it provides you with the opportunity to manage trades and to see how this market is absorbing information around the clock. Let's start with the weekly chart. It shows us that Japanese yen has recently been in a downtrend. However, the U.S. dollar was weaker, and the yen got stronger as buyers entered the yen this past week. The issue now is, will these buyers continue to move the yen higher? The first area of interest on the daily chart is the buying zone that has occurred between 91.80 to 92.15. This indicates that buyers have entered the market between these levels. I'm bearish below 91.75 and I'm bullish above 92.20. It will be important for this market to close above its challenge level of 92.50 by the close of Friday. Japan is a leading manufacturer of consumer electronics, autos, and technology components. Yen can also be considered an alternative investment in times of uncertainty. This means that Japan has a significant exposure to international as well as domestic news. So pay attention to the news on the coronavirus, China and European tariffs, Brexit, Fed action, and the U.S. dollar. Now let's take a look at a few of the fundamental reports coming out this week that could impact the yen. Tuesday, durable goods orders and CB consumer confidence. Wednesday, pending home sales, crude oil inventories, FOMC meeting statement. Fed interest rate decision, FOMC press conference. Thursday, U.S. GDP. In summary, I am bullish on the Japanese yen for this coming week. I'm looking for buying pressure early in the week to move prices higher with the close above its challenge level of 92.50 by the close of Friday. For Market of the Week, I'm Dan Gramza.